Hello everyone, and today on a new vlog of Bosch AEG Fan 00 I'm going to wash some cleaning racks which I acquired from a hangout spot which we recently cleaned in of our friend group. We got a nice bag full of cleaning racks which needs a 60 degree wash with some nice powder detergent to increase cleaning results. And because I have because they are heavily soiled with specifically with sand, I don't want them in the Bosch, so I decided to use my most intensive and aggressive cleaning machine I own. It uses a lot of water. The only thing it doesn't do is spin, and that's what I have a new little spin dryer for, a Miele to be precise. And this VELO, it's a Dutch brand, VELO, was made in 1987, and now I have it after a few owners. I fully restored it, just a few parts were faulty, and those have been replaced, and now it works like day one again, like the day it released in 1987. So I'm just gonna load it. It's this bag full of cleaning rags, so I think a half load program is sufficient. As long as it does a pre-wash, I'm fine with it, because they're extremely, like I said, they're extremely soiled and they need an extra bit of pre-treating with a little bit of detergent. So I'll just throw them in. So then for the pre-wash, I will use formula white detergent. Despite being colored, I want them to have a little bit of that oxy bleach, so it will get clean properly. Here I got a tiny bit for the pre-wash. It goes directly into the drum because it doesn't have a pre-wash compartment for some reason. Well, I'll just leave it open for a bit. And for the main wash, I want to have 35 milliliters of detergent because it's kind of heavily soiled still. So 35, because it's such a small load, will suffice, as it's a concentrated detergent anyway. So it looks like this right now. A nice load of yellow cleaning rags. Here there's 35 milliliters of the same powdered detergent. Then I will close it. Then let's see the 2 kilogram program, which is with a pre-wash, which is B. This knob to B and the program timer to 1. Then I can select a temperature to start it, but I will first make sure the tap is open. And then I've made 2 dots. This one's 40 degrees and this one's for 60 degrees, and I'm obviously gonna choose 60 degrees. And then it will start. Just grab a little magnet to bypass the safety mechanism. So you can see it do a tumble. As you could see, it washed rather intensively, and I will come back to it once it's done. Then I will show you how the spinning is done, as the machine is semi-automatic and it does not spin. So in the end, I will come back maybe in between to film a little to measure how what temperature it did reach in the main wash. But then eventually I will just show you how to spin and, well, how it is dried. Now that Velo is pre-washing all nicely with the intensive tumble. I am going to continue my wash day and share it with you guys. It's currently pre-washing at 30 degrees before going to do the main 60 degrees main wash. Pre-washing at 30 degrees with earth and soil stains helps keeping the loosening up the mud, and it will help releasing those stains more easily on the main wash, especially if you do it with powdered detergent. Then I had this one on allergy plus 60 with the colored towels with Formule Ultra Color Plus. I'm currently washing the things with Ultra Color White, and it is done. So I will take this to the dryer, and then I will turn on the jeans and show you how I wash those. So it's been spun out at 1600 RPM because I want to ensure the shortest drying time. The shorter the dryer is turned on, the less energy it will require to dry your towels. So I estimated it will be drying for about 2 hours, because it's quite a lot, and these things are not washed with softener, so they hold a lot and a lot of moist. I do need to mind that there is one mop in there which may not go in the dryer, because I've had that's something our housekeeping help once told me. She told that those things are expensive and that she had to buy one about every 2 weeks. And that's not supposed to happen. Those mops need to work for at least quite a few years. Seeming it's a kind of a high-end brand, being Vileda. We bought a mop once, and well, we've never stepped away from that brand. Okay, so now the dryer is filled, I am going to turn it to Cotton's Copper Dry Plus. The difference between Copper Dry and Copper Dry Plus is obviously the drying time. This means keep it a little moist, it needs to go in the cupboard. This means make it bone dry and do not leave any moist in. It needs to go in the cupboard. The difference between this and extra dry is that extra dry is more for thick material, and since towels are not that thick, they will go on Copper Dry Plus anyway. Okay, that's that. The drum rollers do be a little squeaky, but if that's all, the dry sterile still works perfectly. So I'm not gonna complain about squeaky drum rollers for the time being. I will clean the dryer from the inside this this spring, and then I will also lubricate them once again. Then it's time to adjust the camera a little. Better. So you can see the washing machine. I'll turn it on first because of the weight sensor. I'm going to wash jeans, so it's jeans slash darks, 30 degrees because of color bleeding, 1200 RPM. It will do an interval final spin anyway. intensive plus, so it washes 10 minutes extra, and 1.5 hours is perfect. Idos 1, which contains color riese, or at least Weisser Riese color, as it's called in Germany, this one. And it's loaded up. I think I've got about 5 or 6 pairs of jeans. Which is perfect for a weekly jeans wash. Turned on. And then it will start sensing for how much detergent it needs. Probably around 40 to 50 milliliters. As it's quite an average load. Dispense the detergent. It's still kind of weird to not put in detergent, as it's in the tanks and it will be dispensed for you, but sometimes I just can't really grasp the idea of the machine doing it for me. Alright, that one's on. Let's turn on the higher, because I still got the wash of my parents, a load of darks. That one is the basket is quite full, so I want that to be washed. So time to do a wash in the higher. I will use a Lenore sensitive detergent for that, as my mother has allergies to certain perfumes. There was this detergent which is scented, which she can handle, but I hate the scent of that. So thanks to the King of Bleach, I now have this sensitive detergent, and it's amazing. I really love that detergent because it smells fresh. It smells hygienical, if that has a smell, you know, that kind of smell which comes from those hygienically washed stuff. And at least this is a detergent which suds nicely, so all in all it's far better than Robijn Black. Let me turn on the water. Let's load it, and then I'll grab the detergent. I just need to make sure I divide colorids from darks properly, because that's some kind of a thing sometimes. Okay. Wait, like I said, I've promised myself to do underwear separately from regular clothing this time, because I want, once in a while, I wash them hygienically. Not always, because of the soaring energy consumption prices. So yeah, that's kind of a thing. This will be a nice load. And later the underwear goes in higher, in the upper higher, on underwear 60. But this is going, I think, on cottons 40, as cottons has a nice intensive wash routine. so I can use it in a, so it gets clean in a minimal amount of time and uses a really lovely amount of water. So, well, excluding the underwear, really make sure the load stays small. I will wait with drying that stuff for the upper hire to finish later on, because then I have a reason to dry everything with the cleaning towels, which are now in VELO. Cottons, 15 minutes of washing, 99 minutes, 1500 RPM. Perfect. Then I'm going to grab the detergent I need. Oh, it's kind of a half load. I will use this detergent, the Lenore 2-in-1 sensitive washmittel, and it's also a full washmittel, so I can also use it on boil washes if needed. And it contains all the enzymes I like. It's indeed half a half load, so I will use 60 milliliters of detergent, 5 more than advised, so I can make sure the cleaning results are just perfect. And everything suds a lot in this machine, so that's why I need to be careful with my detergent use. So 60 milliliters of this stuff going right in. Start, then it will start to sense, it won't drain before filling up, so that's just fine. The detergent will be used as it's supposed to be used. And now it will start filling. It didn't sink down, but I think it will be on temperature quite quickly, as it's on 40 degrees instead of 60 or 90. So there's that. So I was looking at the VELO on how much degrees it was, and I said it to cut on 60. Well, let's just have a look, because I already know and I wanted to share with you guys, because it's kinda special to heat to this temperature on cut on 60.
Here it is washing away. I will defeat the safety lock once again after the stumble. It's rather sudsy. It is now 71 degrees. And I set it to 60 degrees. Yeah, it's going down right now because it's not heating anymore, but around 70 degrees it is. So I did not expect that. Usually the maximum it heats to 66 degrees on this program, but I didn't expect 70. Well, it's not that bad, because then the racks are getting a proper hygienic wash right now. More proper than on 60 degrees in my opinion. So I won't complain. Those racks are made on boil wash anyway, so. And it's almost done washing. So I will leave it be right now, and I will come back to you when it's time to spin.
Since the lower hire now is rinsing and spinning and all that kind of stuff, it's time to turn on the upper hire with, no, not silk. I do not need to wash silk. No, wrong program again. On underwear, 3 rinses, 15 minutes of washing and 60 degrees, 1000 RPM spin speed. So let's just load it. It's a weird view, but I have to do it like this, because otherwise I have to adjust the camera in a different way. That's too much work for now. So it's just a tiny bit of underwear. And that one's nicely spinning, trying to find the right balance, obviously, because it's a kinda sensitive machine. Oh well. But the spin results on this machine are amazing. For just 1500 RPM, just 1500 RPM, 1200 RPM even comes out practically dry already. Less dry than 1500, but it's amazing what it can achieve with just 1200 RPM. Okay, let's just, because it's so little, I will use just 35 milliliters of the Lenore sensitive. I want 35 milliliters as a bare minimum, but since it's a little amount longer, you do not need that much. Yet again, Lenore sensitive, because it's a perfect detergent from appearance. This amount, right on there, and turn it on. So, and I saw VELO was done, there's a nice dishwasher. I saw VELO was done, so we will go there and we will spin those red. So I'm going to turn it off, water off, this one to the normal position, so I can make it do one final drain after unloading, because there's always some water leaking still. Okay, it doesn't have a drum positioning system, obviously. For an 80s washer that would be extremely modern. So this works fine as well. Then I need to open it, but these springs are gone, so I'll just, they just broke, and the other one still has proper springs, so I can still close it just nicely. And there you can see a nicely washed load of cleaning rags. Just take this one out. It's a semi-automatic machine, so it does not spin. So I'll just load them in the spin dryer and we'll spin them. So these spin dryers have to be loaded quite tactically because of, well, there not being a balance system, because they are kind of old machines. So I'll just load it real quick. It's a 2800 RPM machine, which basically means that it will, due to the small tiny drum, will have the same results as a 1400 RPM spin. And if you just spin it quite long, like let's say 5 minutes, 5 minutes of 1400 RPM, create real nice spin results. And then your dryer will take very, very little time, even if you have a heat pump. This will go all right at once. Because unbalance is no joke, it kind of broke my previous handle of the previous machine. So let's see how it does. Something got stuck between the space and the drum, but that's not the case. Let's continue.
now with this thin one I clean up the VELO. And then this one still needs to drain, so okay, now we're going on to the next wash, which I have, and that's something I'll do after I hang the jeans. Those towels just came in of both stock, and I will boil wash them, because it's been a while since I boil washed in the Bosch, and since I boil washed those cleaning towels, so let's just do that. So now it's time for a boil wash, which I usually don't do, but now it's kind of needed. So 90 degrees, speed perfect. I do want a pre-wash and one extra rinse. That'll be a good time for a boil wash, and 1600 RPM obviously, because it's going to be tumble dried later. So let's load it in the washer. Oh, and of course idles too, because that's a full wash meter. Since it's an industrial load of laundry, I do not care too much about it. It just needs to be washed properly and hot. And it's being done with this detergent, which is a universal / full wash meter. So that's just that's what's needed for this load. And yes, colors and whites go all in together, because it's an industrial wash. No care is needed at all. There's some pretty nasty stains in there, so the high temperatures are kinda welcome. Usually 60 would be enough, but since it's too long ago that I boiled these, I'm gonna do a boil wash anyway. So time to turn it on. Pre-wash for pre-treating those stains, and well, the boil temperature for the disinfection, including in combination with the liquid detergent. After sensing, it will dose for the pre-wash, which is a little bit of soap, and at the main wash obviously there will be more soap. Or detergent, I should say. Tiny bit of soap, and then it will start pre-washing. It will just fill up water until it has enough. I must thank you guys a lot. I had a blast doing this wash day. This is the first time in ages that I had fun in my hobby again, and I hope that we can share more of these vlogs. Maybe one time a detergent review or whatever, because I have some really interesting sunil and that kind of stuff laying around. So I will keep you updated on how my detergents are. The Frisse Reus and the Color Reus are really nice, but for a review I want to review something I've never used or haven't used in like ages, which is sunil,
We had it available once, but since it's gone, I found it in Germany and now I really want to test it again. I hope you enjoyed and have a nice day.